Now, we know that the men and ape, they were having the common type of ancestors. So now we will discuss about the flow chart of the human evolution. And in the class Hominidae, they were having six genera. What were the six genera? There are six genera of the class Hominoidea. They are, the first one is Ramapithecus, the second one is Caenopithecus, third Australopithecus, fourth Paranthropus, fifth Zinzanthropus, and sixth is Homo habilis onwards. This genera Homo will start from Homo habilis. There are six genera of the class Hominidae that are Ramapithecus, Caenopithecus, Australopithecus, Paranthropus, Zinzanthropus, and Homo, that is from Homo habilis onwards. These were the six genera. Now we will start our flow chart. Firstly, we have started from the order Primata. From order Primata, three individuals were evolved. From order Primata, the two suborders were formed, and from these two suborders, the first order was Prosimians. Here they were formed lemurs, lorsiers, and tarsiers. And here the second was Anthropoidea, or we can say that early Anthropoidea. So these were eliminated as the offshoot because these organisms developed and they fossilized, they were extinct. No other organism has been evolved from the suborder Prosimian. After the production of these three individuals, the order Prosimian has been eliminated, the individuals has been extincted. The only remaining suborder was Anthropoidea. Now, these were the and from Anthropoidea, the early anthropods has been developed. From these early anthropods, they developed the primitive monkeys. The primitive monkeys has been developed, and from these primitive monkeys, again the two individuals have been formed. From this primitive monkey, the one was formed that was Oligopithecus, and the next one, which was eliminated as the offshoot, that was New World monkeys. From this Oligopithecus, again two type of individuals were formed. The first was hominoids. Oligopithecus evolved into the hominoids and also to the new old world monkeys. But this old world monkeys were offshooted. That is, Oligopithecus evolved into the hominoids and these hominoids again evolved into the next individuals. But this old world monkeys, they were developed and eliminated. Likewise, these new world monkeys, they were also developed and eliminated. From both of these individuals, no other individual has been developed. Therefore, they were considered as the offshooted animals. From these hominoids developed Propleopithecus and Limnopithecus. These were the two individuals that has been developed from the hominoids, Propleopithecus and the Limnopithecus. And the offshoot was of Pleopithecus. Sorry, this Propleopithecus and Egyptopithecus. Propleopithecus and Egyptopithecus were the two individuals that has been evolved from the hominoids, and the offshooted animal was Pleopithecus. Now, from this Propleopithecus and Egyptopithecus, the new individual which was arises, or the link which was formed in the lineage of the human evolution, was Procaucil. From this Procaucil, the another link which was formed was, found was Dryopithecus. This Dryopithecus were considered as the common type of ancestor for the men and the apes, which has been evolved from the Procaucil. And roughly speaking, this Procaucil is also considered as the ancestors, or the common type of ancestors for the apes and the men. But generally, we used to say that Dryopithecus are considered as the common ancestors of the men and the apes. From this Dryopithecus evolved Shivapithecus. This Shivapithecus again gives rise to the two individuals. The first which came into the hominoidae family. The first individuals which were evolving of the hominoidae family, and the second one of the Pongidae. The next link was of superfamily Hominidae and of the superfamily Pongidae. We have studied that in superfamily Pongidae there are three apes, or Pongidae is also called as ape line, and the three apes were orangutan, gorilla and chimpanzee. Orangutan, gorilla and chimpanzee, which has been evolved from the family, super family Pongidae. Now, this hominoidae, from this hominoidae, they started men, or we can say that human line. Human line started from this hominoidae. This hominoidae gives rise to the another link is Ramapithecus. These individuals have been evolved around 15 billion years ago. the Ramapithecus. The next one is Ramapithecus and Caniapithecus also. They both were evolved at the same time around 15 billion years ago. And the next link after Ramapithecus and Caniapithecus was Australopithecus. And this Australopithecus have been evolved around 10 billion years ago. The next link after the Australopithecus is Homo habilis. These Homo habilis was the next link. And from this Homo habilis, the Homo erectus has been generated. The class of the Homo erectus, or we can say that the Homo erectus species have been evolved from the Homo habilis. After this Homo habilis, these Homo habilis were also called as handyman. And after Homo habilis, the next link was Java ape man. The name of, or the new name of the Java ape man is Homo erectus. Erectus. After the Java ape man, the next link is pecking man. The name of this pecking man, or the scientific name, is Homo erectus pekinensis. After pecking man, the next link is Heidelberg man. The scientific name of this Heidelberg man is Homo erectus Heidelberg genesis. And after the Heidelberg, we are continuing here. After Heidelberg, there started, or the next link was pre-Neanderthal man. Pre-Neanderthal man was the next link after Heidelberg man. This pre-Neanderthal man again gives rise to the two individuals. The first was Cro-Magnon man, and its scientific name is Homo sapien fossilis. And the offshoot of Neanderthal man, its name is Homo sapiens neanderthalensis. Neanderthalensis. Its name is Homo sapiens neanderthalensis. Neanderthal man. From this, after this pre-Neanderthal man, the Homo sapiens, Homo sapien line started from Homo habilis. The Homo erectus was started, and after pre-Neanderthal man, Homo sapiens was started. And pre-Neanderthal man gives rise to the Cro-Magnon man. Its name is Homo sapien fossilis. And after Cro-Magnon man, there is the development of today's man, and the scientific name is Homo sapiens sapiens. So this is the whole flow chart of the evolution, of the human evolution. That human evolution, we had started our human evolution from the order Primata, and this order Primata has been divided into two suborders. The first one is Prosimian and the second one is early anthropoids. This Prosimian was eliminated as the offshoot, because the three individuals that have been developed in the prosimians, they do not give rise to the another one, and they were extincted after some time. The individual which gives rise to the another individual was the early anthropoids. They gives rise to the primitive type of monkeys, and this primitive type of monkeys, they gives rise to the Oligopithecus individuals, and they had also gives rise to the New World monkeys. That were eliminated as the offshoot. That is, they were eliminated after some times. From this Oligopithecus, the new individual that have been arrived was hominoids. And this were again the another offshoot was Pleopithecus, and from the hominoids the two individuals were included, these were not hominoids, early hominoids. From these early hominoids, the two individuals were developed, Propleopithecus and Egyptopithecus. This Propleopithecus and Egyptopithecus gives rise to the Procaucil, and Procaucils gives rise to the Dryopithecus. This Dryopithecus are considered as the ancestors or the common ancestors of the apes and the man in the human evolution lineage. Now this Dryopithecus, they gives rise to the Shivapithecus. This Shivapithecus again give rise to the two super families or the two super classes, that is Hominoidae and Pongidae. Pongidae were offshooted because it develops three apes, that is orangutan, gorilla and chimpanzees. They were eliminated after some time, and the only link which was again evolved was of Hominoidae. That Hominoidae again gives rise to the Ramapithecus. From the Ramapithecus, the human line was started. The Ramapithecus and Caniapithecus, they were both evolved at the same time, around 15 billion years ago. And from the Ramapithecus, the next link was Australopithecus, around 10 million years ago. Then Australopithecus, after the Australopithecus, the next link was Homo habilis. They were also called as handymen. And the next link after Homo habilis was Java ape man. After Java ape man, Peking man. And the next link was Heidelberg man. Heidelberg man gives rise to the pre-Neanderthal man. And after pre-Neanderthal man, at the same time, two individuals were developed. One was offshooted, that is Neanderthal man, and that which was included in the lineage of the human evolution was Cro-Magnon man. The scientific name of the Cro-Magnon man is Homo sapien fossilis. This Homo sapien fossilis again evolved into the today's man, and its scientific name is Homo sapiens sapiens. So this was the flow chart of the human evolution that we have discussed. In the next video or in the next lecture, we will discuss about the characteristics of the individuals which have been appeared. We will be discussing some characteristics of the Dryopithecus, Ramapithecus, Australopithecus, and the individuals which have been evolved in the Homo erectus and Homo sapiens. And after that, we will continue the geological time scale.